Today, my presentation is basically is on theoretical formulation on exact thermal response under ultrafast pulse laser irradiation on copper nanoflame based on dual phase lag model. I am Dr. Jaydeep Datta, Assistant Professor of Department of Mechanical Engineering, MCKB Institute of Engineering, West Bengal. So again, once again, I would like to thank particularly Mr. Praveen Kothala, President of STEIIO, for giving me this opportunity to present my research work, and I'm going to start right now. So basically, the topic of this presentation lies on the development of exact analytical solution of thermal response, which will be carried out, which will be actually developing during ultrafast laser irradiation process on copper nanoflame. So when I'm talking about ultrafast copper nanoflame, so obviously I need to understand microscale heat transfer. Means I need to more detail on what is happening at the microscale level. So at this particular case, the most important thing is selection of mathematical model, because I'm going to develop theoretical analysis and obviously exact analytical solution. The prime reason behind going for exact analytical solution is because this kind of solution actually gives you the exact one, means there is no error is involved. But once again, each and every model has certain deficiency also. I'm nothing but dealing with linear non-homogeneous model, but with higher order partial differential equation, mixed higher order partial differential equation. But in case of non-linear model, if it is non-linear one, then obviously analytical solution is sometimes difficult to develop. Now the motivation behind development of this analytical solution is basically comes from the literature survey, which actually gives me a bit idea to rethink on this particular case, because most of the researchers have carried out this development of solution of thermal response based on numerical modeling. But what I feel, numerical modeling is fine, but if it is a non-linear one, then it would be very good. But when I am having a certain linear homogeneous differential equation, so in that case, or I can say linear non-homogeneous differential equation, in that case, if you have the opportunity of development of analytical as well as numerical one, then I should go for exact solution, which is nothing but analytical one. But again, numerical solution has certain advantages also. So basically, based on the literature survey, I have found very few availability of very few research papers, particularly on exact solution of the temperature distribution, which is nothing but developed while and development of this ultrafast pulse laser heating. Now the come to the selection of mathematical model. It is very important. So we have found that in case of microscale heat transfer, dual phase lag model, DPL model, gives you the best solution, because it actually captures both microscale level as well as, means both microscale in case of time level as well as the space level. So basically it nothing but this particular model consists of two thermal lags. So now the lag concept is not actually available in conventional, I can say, microscopic approach. Now, if I am talking about microscopic approach, then obviously I need to deal with that. But in macroscopic approach, so if I consider basic governing differential equation of heat conduction, then it is Fourier's law of heat conduction. But in Fourier's law of heat conduction, what it actually says, it is basically, this postulate is basically depends upon the infinite energy propagation. But in case of infinite energy, when infinitely propagates energy, then that means I am nothing but giving some amount of heat in a certain object as soon as temperature gradient will be developed. This is what Fourier's law of heat conduction says. But in actual case, when I am giving a certain amount of heat to a particular object, it needs certain time after that temperature gradient is going to be developed. So that certain small time, that gives you the lag. So that lag has not been considered in case of Fourier's law of heat conduction. So that lag, when I'm talking about a microscopic structure, then I need to consider that. But in case of dual phase lag, that actually model is developed by Professor D.Y. Zhou. So he first invented this particular model, as well as he analyzed this thing with ultra fast laser on gold nanofilm. His most of the research work is based on gold nanofilm to understand what is the thermal response, what is the orientation, what will be the lag time for different metals. Now, experimentally, he has found out certain, the thermal lags for different metals. But remember, it is only for metals. But for, if I am going talking about for alloys, then it is actually unavailable till now. Means experimental thermal lags. So based on that, based on that fact, this particular research work is development of exact analytical solution based on dual phase lag model for temperature distribution for copper nanofilm. I have considered 5 nanometer copper nanofilm, and based on that I have implemented a certain laser heat source. Now, laser heat source basically has been modified here. So I'm going for my next slide. So I think introduction portion, ultra fast pulse laser, basically this makes a remarkable impact on microscale manufacturing, basically micro machining, surface treatment, structural health monitoring of nanofilms. So now how laser works, I think it doesn't require any introduction, so I'm not going for it, because it is very basic things. But ultra fast pulse laser, they are basically right now captivating very much interest in science and engineering application because of pulse achievement in duration in the order of picosecond to femtosecond order. So basically lasers, pulses are broadly classified as long, that means 0.1 to 50 microsecond, then short 1 to 200 nanosecond, then ultra short less than 10 picosecond. Okay, so for material processing, this kind of ultra-fast laser machining process is actually gives you very high precision, better flexibility, robustness, as well as sometimes gives you a better processing when if you do not have any unavoidable expansion. So this kind of flexibility is available. So because of this, ultrafast pulse laser are very much effective while I'm dealing with a microscopic approach. So from the literature review, what I found out, first of all, due to time constraint, I have not put all the literature survey. I have kept only the important ones. So from the literature survey, I have found, as I told, I have found a very few analytical solution, particularly on dual phase lag heat conduction model. Now, most of the works are carried out on gold nanofilms only. Most of the works. So I'm not going for individual one, but again, I'm telling a very few work, I think 2 or 3 works are available on development of exact analytical solution, whereas most of the works are based on numerical one. So the research gap, what I told that, apart from this analytical solution, development of analytical solution, what I have found that, when I'm dealing with the mathematical model, that means I need to consider a laser heat source, which I need to rely, means the heat source, obviously what I am going to select, that is I should make it in the form of real one, means I at least I should try, but there are certain mathematical constraints also. I cannot, there are certain non-linearities are available in actual experiments, in actual real life. So in that case, that would be very difficult to capture in mathematics. But what I have seen that most of the models are based on Gaussian distribution, simple one, but a few things are missing. That a kind of thing that when actually a laser beam collides on the substrate surface, means from the basic, very basic point of view. So when a laser beam collides on the substrate surface, a certain fraction of energy is reflected and absorbed. So hence, the energy falls on the surface from the laser source is not exactly utilized to achieve the melting point. So that means the fraction of energy is lost during the source-substrate interaction. So what I have found that most of the cases, in most of the researchers, or I can say none of the researchers, have not considered absorptivity and reflectivity factor, these two factors, particularly for the substrate surface, in the mathematical expression of laser source. So in present research work, we have I have actually considered this one. So again, this is the most important one. Another one is, mostly they are based on numerical modeling. Analytical models are very less, particularly on development of temperature dish distribution. The third point is, what I have found, mostly the research papers are based on gold nanofilm. There are a few cases of gold and chromium nanofilm, but apart from this, none of the materials have not been analyzed. So in that case, so this is the objective of the present research work, to development of exact analytical solution, but in one dimensional manner. The second one is, the substrate surface is considered as copper nanofilm of 5 nanometer length. Now the impact of relaxation time lags, they are actually available in the 12 phase lag thermal model. And the thermal history at different depths of substrate metal has been estimated on behalf of the present mathematical model. Now, in this regard, I would like to again mention that as it is an exact analytical solution, what I found that the source of dual phase lag model, when I'm interacting with the energy equation, when I'm combining this, it is basically comes under higher order mixed partial differential equation, as well as the non-homogeneous form, which is basically the laser source. So it is better that I will go for directly mathematical modeling, then it will be good. So in this case, I can show it here, that this is the governing differential equation of dual phase lag postulate as developed by Dr. D.Y. Zhou. So this is the heat source, the Q. Okay. So along with this, tau Q, which is the thermal relaxation time for heat flux, and tau T, this is the thermal relaxation time for temperature gradient. So these two things, if I keep it zero, then you can consider this is similar to what it is called Fourier's law of heat conduction. So this is the new innovation part of this dual phase lag model. Now, when this model has been clubbed with the energy equation, the dual phase lag heat conduction model will be given in terms of one dimensional form as per the present assumption. So that is in the form of equation number 2, where Q is the, this particular term, capital Q, is the laser source. Okay. So the laser source, what I have selected here, it is actually represented in equation number 3, where you can see the two terms are available, which is the new terms, or I can say the modified terms based on the existing research work. It is called RF and RA. RF is called reflectivity, RA is called absorptivity. So these two terms will be basically dependent upon what is the substrate surface, basically the metal I'm going to utilize. X is particular the direction, I0 is the laser intensity, TP is the pulse time, phi is the penetration depth. So this is the schematic diagram of present research work, where you can see now this is the origin of heat source. Okay, so this is my dimension L. Okay, so this is my origin at x equals to 0. From here, I have considered one section, and along this direction, I'm going to see what is my temperature dish distribution. So this is my boundary conditions at x equals to 0. Along the one phase to another phase, I have considered temperature gradient equals to 0. Now, one can ask that what is the purpose of putting this boundary condition? This boundary condition is basically second kind boundary condition based on the heat transfer concept. Because when in the differential equation, that means I'm talking about equation number 2, in the model itself, I have the heat source. So first of all, there is no relevant to mention the external heat source here. That means no finite heat source will be available at the boundary surface. Now, as it is a theoretical model, the idea behind impose of this second kind boundary condition, the prime motivation is basically I need to consider that my two surfaces are insulated. That means there won't be no heat transfer. So that means for effective heating. So there won't be any heat losses. So again, I'm telling this is one consideration. There are few research paper also where first kind boundary conditions are also implemented. That means at x equals to zero, there will be one finite temperature. At x equals to L, there will be one finite temperature. Again, I'm telling there are certain research paper also that at x equals to zero and x equals to L, they kept it that it is mixed boundary condition, third kind. That means it will be of conductive convective boundary condition. So each and every boundary condition has certain limitations, but what I found for effective heating, these boundary conditions are also utilized by some of the researchers, and I have considered this as a boundary condition. So the initial condition, so at time equals to zero, one constant initial condition means Ti, it is the temperature at T equals to zero, means at time equals to zero, this is one constant temperature. Now I need another initial condition because my governing differential equation, second order time derivative is available. So to solve this particular equation, I need another one initial condition, which is delta T with respect to time at T equals to zero Q, which is a function of x equals to zero. That means what is the laser source I have considered? If I make it at t equals to zero, what will be the mathematical expression? That is my initial condition divided by C. So this capital C is total specific heat. So rho multiplied by C. Okay, so this is equation number 5. Now mathematical part is actually very huge. So that's why I'm not able to include it here. Otherwise, it will take much more time, as well as the slides will be very much larger in numbers. So finally, I have implemented two mathematical methods. One is Duhamel's theorem. So first of all, if I look back into equation number 2, I can say that there is one non-homogeneous part is available, which is nothing but this 1 by k into Q plus tau Q into del Q del T. This is nothing but the non-homogeneous part of the equation. So to remove this part, and as well as to make this equation into the homogeneous one, to solve this particular equation, I need to apply Duhamel's theorem. Now, after implementation of Duhamel's theorem, if one can look back the second term of the left-hand side of the equation, tau T into del T, del D into delta del square T by del X2. This is nothing but higher order mixed derivative. So to tackle mixed derivative, as I'm telling, I have already told, there are very few analytical solutions are available. Now most of the research papers, I think 3 papers are available right now. So in that 3 papers, they have implemented Laplace transform method, but I have implemented finite integral transform method. Why? The reason is, first of all, Laplace transform method, finally I need to make it in inverse form. Means I need to rely upon the expression of what is coming after solution. Then I need to apply the inverse theory to get the solution. But in case of finite integral transform, first of all, the objective of finite integral transform method is to convert one higher order expression to the lower order one. Okay, so that's why in the solution I have got 3 different cases, because if I solve equation number 2 with finite integral transform, then it finally converts this higher order non-homogeneous equation into second order linear homogeneous form. So the second order linear homogeneous form, it basically has 3 case studies. One is for 2 different roots, one is for 2 similar roots, third one is for no real roots. So if I solve this with appropriate steps, then I have got the 3 solutions. So not 3 solutions, there are 3, there are basically the solution is 1, but it is different for 3 different cases. So the first case is, for 2 different roots, the solution is given as equation 6a. Then for 2 similar roots, it is given as equation 6b. Then it is for equation 6c. So this is my mathematical part, but again, I'm telling you, I am making it in a very brief manner. So in the resultant discussion, first of all, I need to validate my mathematical model with the published numerical one. So what I have done, I have taken the data, but again, I'm telling that on the copper nanofilm, this is the first work I have carried out, but due to lack of the research papers on copper nanofilm, I have validated my data on gold nanofilm with exactly the same variable, whatever utilized in the published work. So this is the variation with the numerical model. And this is the experimental work, which is actually produced by the inventor of the dual phase lag model, actually Professor D.Y. Zhou. And experimental data means in case of numerical data, the variation was 2.78%. And in case of experimental one, it is 1.8%. Now come back to the temperature distribution with respect to time when I plot it. So basically this particular graphical representation gives you the idea about actually the difference between dual phase lag model as well as Fourier's model. I have already told that this two thermal lag time, tau q and tau t, it actually characterizes the efficiency of dual phase lag model. Now experimentally, Professor Zhou has been found out that for copper nanofilm, the tau q and tau t values are 3.78 picosecond and 10 picosecond. It is for an experimental observation of a plate upon copper nanofilm of 5 nanometer. So that's why 5 nanometer has been selected to understand whether it is correct or not. Means my theoretical model is correct or not. And I0, that means the laser intensity, is considered as 100 joule per meter square. Pulse time is 0.1 picosecond. And the penetration depth is 0.25 nanometer. And what I have found, this tau q, this bold portion of this region, tau q is equals to 3.78 and tau t is equals to 10 picosecond. This gives me the maximum peak. And when I'm going to deviate the tau q value, means the thermal relaxation time for heat flux, like 0.1 second, 2.5 second, then I have got the other peaks. So this is basically the quantitative difference between the actual one and the ideal one. Okay. Now, peak temperature, I have found out that for Fourier's model. Now, for Fourier's model, there is basically two conditions. Either tau q and tau t, it can be zero, or tau q and tau t will be same. Now, tau q and tau t value, if I make it zero, then mathematically it is not possible because it is at the denominator term. So instead of that, what I have done, I have considered tau q is equals to 10 picosecond and tau t is equals to 10 picosecond, means both are same magnitude. And what I have done, I have converted this particular mathematical model into the Fourier's form and I have solved. And what I have got, it is basically at the same temperature distribution I have got. So that means the consideration of dual phase lag model into the transformation of Fourier's model, it is basically both are correct. And at this particular experimental value of tau q and tau t, I have got the highest peak. So this is basically heating cycle and cooling cycle has been given here. Now this particular data has been plotted for 5 nanometer, for the 5 nanometer copper nanofilm for different time. Now for different time domain, I have got this particular S curve. The curve is considered to be X because this figure also validates the, means actually shows you the accuracy of the model as well as the code also. Because in left hand side and right hand side, if you can look it very carefully, then both left and right hand side, this particular curve is perpendicular to the axis. That means so temperature gradient is zero. Both this x equals to zero and x equals to L. So the next part is temperature response measure along the various depths. So when I'm going to measure at the surface at x equals to zero nanometer, I have got the maximum peak. That means if this surface, on this particular surface, the laser heat source has been irradiated. So obviously this top surface will be much more higher. And when I'm going for the downward, that means from 1, 2, 3, gradually the temperature is decreasing manner. So that means physical significance wise, this also correct. And this also gives me one of the important criteria about the innovation part of this particular theoretical work. So if I have considered optical property like absorptivity as well as the reflectivity, so this 0.65 and 0.60 directly taken from the material handbook for this particular copper nanoflip surface, and with certain this other thermophysical variables are like this I0 dp, then phi tau t. This tau q and tau t basically selected from the experimental value, as I have already shown. So I have got this difference that if I have not utilized the property, means Ra and Rf, then temperature distribution is very much high. But if I am considering this, that means when the lost energy I have considered, then temperature is less, which is bit logical than without consideration. So the conclusion, I think I have mentioned already during this particular expressions as well as the graphical representations. So mainly the effect of tau q and tau t has been analyzed, the efficiency of dual phase lag model as well as the successful transformation of dual phase lag model to Fourier model has been analyzed. But here one thing I would like to mention that as well as one more thing, the source substrate interaction during this absorptivity and this consideration of absorptivity and reflectivity also successfully placed here. Another one thing that though dual phase lag model I have selected, but as the source substrate interaction basically electron and lattice interaction. So if there is a possibility of making it two temperature model, though two temperature model has been already formed, but to get the exact solution, it is very difficult. Then we have already made one numerical one. But I guess if analytical solution of this two temperature model means separately one energy equation for electron as well as separately one expression for phonon means lattice, then it would be the better one, I guess. So this is it from my side. Thank you so much. And if you have any queries, you can ask.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Professor, for your wonderful speech. And I'll leave some time here. If anyone have any question or comment, go ahead and ask Professor Joydeep.
I have one question.
Yes.
Related to the temperature curve, what you shown.
Okay.
There is a sudden fall in temperature and it's taking only picosecond time. So from 650 to 100 degree. How it is possible?
Sir, actually the case is basically in both the cases means the temperature, first of all, it is increasing, then it is fall. It is heating
okay,
cycle
that as is well okay. as the cooling but, cycle. You know, there's some delay mechanism is there. Immediately temperature cannot fall in picosecond order.
Yes, sir. That is the main thing to analyze it in dual phase lag model. That's why, sir, temperature model, then I think it would be much more better temperature response we may expect. So that's why at the last I have told that though I have analyzed this model, but if I'm able to make it in another one level, another micro level, that means if I consider electron temperature separately as well as the lattice temperature, then I can club it, then it would be far better.
But you will be agree that the thermal signals move slow movement, I mean the transmission, right?
Okay.
Thermal signals are slower, not like a optical signal. So okay. Even if you do this thing with the picosecond laser pulses, it's very difficult to believe that picosecond order there's a drastic fall in the temperature. 650 to 100 degrees centigrade. I think it's a violation of Newton's pulling law. So suppose how the heat is being transmitted or shared by the surrounding atmosphere, how it is possible in such a fast manner? Right or wrong? Newton's pulling law is the most fundamental law. Even if I use a femtosecond or picosecond laser, it cannot be that much fast.
Okay, so that means there must be certain lags, another one level of
lag. I think there's something is missing, maybe in calculation somewhere, because I'm doing acoustic and the thermal signal measurements. So we used to record and measure those signals. And it is millisecond order, not, your things are in picosecond. How it is happening? If it is possible in picosecond, then I can record acoustic signal using a wavelength. And that is not possible. It is a very challenging task. So I'm a practical person. I'm raising this question on the basis of my practical difficulty.
Sure.
So people are using
nanosecond. I need to look back this equation.
Because we already verified in the laboratory with different type of designs and cells. Picosecond is really unbelievable. I mean, it's very difficult to believe.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.